All right, as a little demo, let's try writing a program that prints letters A through Z. So I'm going to start with the first instruction, as always. I'm going to do a for loop. So first I need to initialize my looping variable, which will be 2, and then I will enter the loop like so. That should be fine as a first instruction. So now we're going to build our loop. We want to know when we have to stop, which is when the value we get is, or like our iterator is at 26. So we need 26, and then we subtract the iterator value. So that's 2. So let's actually store this in a maybe a temporary variable, like 4. And then after we've done that, we have to do a branch. So we have to dereference a list containing either, let's say, 9, which is when we're done with this program, or 5 when we're continuing with the program. So that's our list of instructions or that we can evaluate. And then we will index into it with the temporary value we just have, that we just calculated, the 26 minus our iterator value. But actually, we need to make sure that we only take the sign of that expression. So that's plus. And this will either be, so let's see, if 26 minus our iterator, let's say I, so 26 minus I, if that's 0, then we want, yeah, then we want the first expression. Otherwise, we want the second one. So this is fine. So let's start our instruction 5. So this will be where we actually do the work. So we're going to print a value, which will be the ASCII code for A, which is 65, plus the iterator value, which is 2. And after we've done that, we need to increment, we need to store the result of incrementing our iterator value by 1. And then we just need to do the loop again. So I think that should work. And then the only thing we still need to define is when we're done, let's print a new line, which is 10. And then just return, well, let's just return an empty list, for instance. That should be fine. Let's see if this works. It does.